This video demonstrates how ChromEx can be used to create and implement exams in a Google G Suite environment. This video is from the teacher's perspective. One of the ways to get to ChromEx is to navigate to www.chromex.io and log in with your Google account. Using your existing Google account greatly reduces the time spent provisioning and administrating teachers' and student accounts. Now that I've logged in, I can see the sign out button up to the right of the window. Here you can also change language if required. To the left, you can see cost center, which is only visible if you are a member of more than one cost center. Multiple cost centers can be useful for teachers who administer exams at different schools. Show all shows all the cost centers that exist on the domain. At the top of the screen, you can find a Google Slides presentation with instructions for using ChromEx. In the left menu, you can also navigate to the exam archive, support, and feedback sections. The majority of the screen is used to display your exam. Exams can also be archived. Archived exams can be restored or reused at a later date. The gray Google Drive icon indicates whether or not an exam has been submitted. In the left margin, we can see a notification that an exam has expired. There are two ways to create an exam in ChromEx. This video demonstrates how it can be done via the ChromEx application. The alternative is to create an exam directly from Google Classroom using our Classroom plugin. Let's create a new exam by clicking on the icon down to the right. If you can see the configuration menu, it means your administrator has created different exam configurations for you to choose from. Different configurations can be used to limit the teacher's options for creating certain types of exam. This is useful when exams have to adhere to specific standards set by national exam boards, where, for example, exams need to be anonymized or require certain security options. Pre-made configurations can save the teacher time and avoid mistakes. Learn more about configuration options in our administrative video. Choose a title for the exam along with a course code or basic instructions. The start time for the exam determines when the student can start the exam. After the exam end time has passed, the student is unable to start an exam. Based on teacher feedback, we have made it possible for students to continue a current exam for 10 minutes after the end time has passed. Once the 10 minutes has passed, the student will be unable to submit the exam. The teacher also has the ability to extend the time for an exam if needed. You can set the default language and allow spell checking if required. By choosing anonymized student submissions, you have the ability to anonymize all submitted exams during the assessment process. After the exam is assessed, you can relink the student to their respective exam. To increase anonymity, all exams will first appear in Google Drive 45 minutes after the exam time has expired. Make it near impossible to establish who has submitted an exam based on when the student has left the examination environment. Next, you can increase the security of the exam by adding a PIN code for starting, resuming, and submitting exams. If you enable submissions using iPads or Safe Exam Browser to use ChromEx on a PC or Mac, you are required to use a Restore Exam PIN code. If you enable submissions to be handed in using the URL student.chromex.io, we treat the submission as insecure, and you or the school is responsible for securing the exam environment, for example by using a mobile device management tool or the Microsoft Take a Test app. Now, after creating an exam, it's time to decide which students to assign the exam to. I now have three options. The first option is to add individual students using their name or email address. ChromEx utilizes an autocomplete function and double checks that the student has a G Suite account. I can also add a group of students using Google Groups. The group is added to the list of students. Teachers using Google Classroom can add students from their classroom using the same process. After adding the students, I am now able to check the list and add or remove students as required. This can be useful for students who are absent from the exam. On the left of the student's name, I can see that the student haven't opened the exam, and to the right, I can see that the student haven't handed in their exam yet. I can type to search to quickly find students, or use the filter control on the right to find all students matching a certain criteria. Under the Teacher tab, I can add extra teachers both individually or by using groups. This is useful for allowing other teachers to correct my students' exam. We see this as a complement to the anonymous exam function. Under the Resources tab, I can add exam information and questions to be made available for the student during the exam. ChromEx supports the use of most file formats that are compatible with Google Drive. Along with documents, we've seen teachers adding maps, YouTube videos, and much more. There is also an option to add a graphical calculator if needed. Let me now add some example resources. If your students are using Chromebooks for their exam, you can also add web pages from the internet as resources, for example, Wikipedia articles or web dictionaries. Finally, we have the exam log, where you during and after the exam will be able to see information on students starting, stopping, resuming exams, PIN code failures, and connectivity issues. The exam is now ready, and at the scheduled start time, the students will see the exam once they are logged into the ChromEx exam app on their device. Next video will demonstrate ChromEx from the student's perspective.